wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes. Something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's alright with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Ahead of me seems impossible to face when someone else instead of me always seemed to know the way. Then I look at you and the world's alright with me. Just one look at you, I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Good morning. This is your boy, Jay Madden. You're listening to Coffee Conversation, and we're on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on, even Alexa. That's right, Alexa can make it do what it do. Hope y'all had a great night rest, had a great show yesterday on Life After the Collar. Hope you go back. If you have not seen that, go back and see that. Make sure you're following me also on YouTube, my YouTube channel, Life After the Collar YouTube channel. Make sure you go on there and check that out as well and be a part of that. I need to grow that to 1,000 so that we can start doing some special things with that channel there. All right. So y'all make sure y'all hang out with me on that channel right there. All right. Cool beans. I appreciate you. I truly, truly, truly do appreciate you. I wanted to talk about, really just more of a motivational type thing. It may not take me long to do it, but my conversation is simply this. When you sow it, leave it. When you sow it, leave it. It comes from the mindset of agriculture. When we was growing up in Macon, Georgia, we had enough land to have like huge gardens. Like the garden, you have to have a tractor, not a tiller. You had to have a whole tractor, that type of garden. And when I was younger, we would watch them plant seeds and stuff. And I would recon a seed. Didn't care what kind of seed it was. I would just recon one. And when I got the seed, what I would do, I would take it and I would bury it. But I don't know why I can't say that word tonight. I put it in the ground, put some dirt on it. And then a couple of days later, I didn't see a plant. So I would go and dig it up to see what it was doing. Cover back up. A couple of days later, I didn't see a plant coming out the ground. I'll go uncover it. See what it's doing. I learned a valuable lesson. Then that I disrecognized now. Once you sow the seed, you have to leave the seed where you sowed it so that it can do what it is designed to do. I'll say that again. Once you put that seed in the ground, once you bury that seed, why was it so easy to say it then? Once you bury that seed, leave it alone so that it can do what agriculturists, this people says, let it take root, let it germinate, let it sprout. In other words, let it move in every direction it's supposed to move in. A plant has roots at the bottom that spreads out. That from that seed, the actual plant comes up. But before the seed breaks ground, the roots have to expand. It has to do what it needs to do to nurture it. And it knows how to take care of itself. Stop looking for the seed that you sown. Watch this. The problem when I was a little, I kept looking at the seed. I kept looking for the seed. When your harvest come, it is not going to look like your seeds. You don't plant seeds to give you a whole bunch of more seeds. No, you plant seeds to produce something. It should not look the same way it looked when you put it in the ground. Oh boy. I'm trying to help people out this morning about when you sow into things, when you sow into a company, when you sow into your church, when you sow into people. I know we sit there and we pray the prayer at church when we tithe, with, you know, God giving back 10, 20, 40, 100 fold. Sometimes your blessing is not coming back in money if that's what you sold. And most of the time, it won't come back in money. It will come back in a form that you will be able to get something that will result in money. But it won't come back in money. Stop looking for how you sown into people the same way it came. you may have sown time into somebody or something or some organization. But once you plant that seed, whatever it is, don't go back looking at it. Don't go back trying to uncover it. Don't go back trying to see what it's doing. No. Give and let it be. Do and let it be. Don't sit and wonder where it is, when am I going to get it back, and all this other stuff. No, give it and leave it. Sow it and let it grow. When you allow your seed, because a lot of times we deal with it mentally. We may not go back and say, where's my result? Where's my 10, 20, 30, 100 fold? But we're always looking around for it, looking around for it. I know we expect it, but don't, even in the harvest time, you can't expect it. Don't expect it until you see the fruit, the tree. In other words, I'll help you out. Wow, my mind is going 100 miles an hour right now. It was like being in a garden. You go out there and you just water the dirt. You plant it, you see, you water your dirt, and you just out there, you just waiting. Once the seed break ground, because watch this, all seed is not going to germinate. Once the seed break ground, you'll see a plant come up. When you see that plant grow come up, you can now expect, watch this, you can now expect your harvest. But watch this, you still have work to do. When that plant first come out, it is not automatically going to give you a strawberry. It's not automatically going to give you an apple. You still have time and work to do. I'm going to help you out. You still have time and work to do, which means as that plant is growing, you got to start cultivating it. I'll help you out. You planted the seed. In return, God gave you an idea. You planted a seed. God, in return, gave you an idea. It is up to you to work that idea, to cultivate that idea, to water that idea, to keep the weeds, in other words, the negative thoughts away from that idea. Oh, this is good. I may not even have to do my morning affirmation. This is right here. It's good to me. Once you clear the land and let it grow during the right time, you're going to see whatever fruit or vegetable grown on that plant that you planted. Watch this. Just because you see it don't mean it's time to eat it. Yeah, y'all better catch this one. Just because you see it does not mean it's time for you to eat it. You still have more maturity. It has to get to your season of harvest. In other words, stop trying to grab at things. Watch this. Stop trying to grab at things that has not matured yet. You're grabbing at relationships that has not matured yet. You're grabbing at opportunities that has not matured yet. You're grabbing at different situations that have not matured yet. We're due with too much grabbing before it's harvest season. Just because you see it, does not mean it's time for you to grab it. I'll help you out with a story. Biblically speaking, Jesus was walking, and he said that I'm hungry. And he went to a fig tree. And there were leaves on the fig tree, so he assumed that there were figs on this tree. I use the word assume because if you study the fig tree has two seasons. It produces two seasons of figs. The first season you really don't want to eat from. It is the second season that we really get they pull the figs from. It is the second season that most farmers pull the second. You still can, they're still edible, but the first season is more bitter. But at least you can eat it. Watch this. The figs start growing before the leaves. The figs started growing before the leaves. So he looked at the tree. The tree had leaves, but no food. Okay. In other words, it was the tree didn't have figs, but it had leaves. That's a whole different, I could preach that one right there. I promise you I could preach that one right there. Even though you see the fruit coming off of or growing or the fig or the vegetable, whatever you planted, is coming on the tree. You can see it and you can still pull it off and eat it, but it's not the right season for it. We destroy our real harvest prematurely, taking stuff that is not ready for its season. You have an opportunity to take your seed, plant it, leave it alone, let it do what it do. Once you start seeing it grow, start cultivating around the plant. Start making sure the plant is well taken care of. The buzzards and the birds and stuff is not trying to get at it. You're taking all the weeds. In other words, let me put it, since I was talking agriculture, you meet somebody, let them, you know, you sow into them, you reap it, you cultivate the relationship, you take the weeds away from them, and don't define it as anything, just cultivate it, let it mature. The reason why a lot of us get into so much trouble, we don't allow it to mature into what we think it's going to be. That right there. That right there. We're trying to uncover it and try to make it into something. We planted an apple seed, but rather have bananas. We planted an apple seed, but want. Okay. So not only don't keep digging up your seeds, you plant the seed, uncover, see what it's doing. Like I did when I was a kid. It didn't come up in 2 days, so I uncovered it to see what the seed was doing. I covered it back up. And for every 2 days, I was going on it. I ain't see the plant, but I was messing up its growth. The second thing is expect what you planted. Expect what you sown into the ground. And it's deeper than if you sow money, you're expecting money. No, you're not expecting money. When your heart is right, your heart knows why you are sowing. I remember we would plant in the garden and we'd go out and plant the seeds and we would forget what we planted. We forgot what we planted. Or where we planted what we planted. Let me put it that way. We forgot where we planted certain things. And so we would be, cleaning the garden, making sure it was taken care of, pulling the weeds, all this other stuff. I know y'all don't know anything about that. Y'all city folks don't know nothing about that. So when it was time for the plants to start growing, sometimes we would stop. I thought we planted, cucumbers over there. I thought we planted tomatoes over there. I thought we planted carrots over there. I thought we planted onions over there. When you sowed your seed and you didn't uncover it, just look at what's on its tree and call it what it is. Stop calling your seed your fruit something else. Ooh, this 30 minutes is going to get me. Stop calling it something else. You're only going to get what you planted. I understand that majority of the time we say that we're planting, we sold money. Money is not a seed. Money is an object in which we use as a seed. But the seed is why you are. Why is it that you are sowing? Why is it that you, what purpose are you sowing? And it is not all the time money. Sometimes you sow time. Sometimes you sow the list. There's a plethora of things you can sow a seed with. But that object, that seed, if you look at a seed, you don't see an apple. But in your mind, you plant this seed in the ground. In your mind, you're planting your seed in the ground. It does not look like what you're sowing. Yes, sometimes we do plant things, collard greens, we put a plant in the ground, poke a hole, put a plant, cover it back up, and it comes out that way. My conversation is simply this morning is this. Never stop worrying about what your seed is doing. Just let it do. What is this going to do? Good morning, Michelle. Good morning, Gina. Just let it do what it's going to do. That seed first has to go down before it comes up. I'll say that again. That seed first have to go down, not just down into the ground. When it first sprouts, it starts sprouting its roots. And that one thing, that one little plant would come up through the ground. Do you realize how strong? Have you ever touched a blade of grass with your hand? Gina, I know you can't because you'll break out over everything. But when you touch a blade of grass, it is real flimsy. More flimsy, like when you walk on it, it bends and pops back up. Bends and pops back up. It's that thin. You ever ask yourself, how is it that you could plant a seed in the ground, and when it comes through the hard dirt, like you could thump on the dirt and it's hard, you could walk on the dirt and it won't move, but a thin plant will break ground? You ever wonder how that, because it's taking its time slowly moving things out of its way. It's moving difficult things out of the way so that it can spring, it can break ground. Your seed is taking its time to move things out of your way so it can break ground so you can have a harvest. Will you plant it, leave it, forget it? Plant it, leave it, forget it. And let it do what it's designed to do. Don't keep running back to God saying, God, I planted this seed, but I gave you this, and I did this, and I did this, and I did. Do it and leave it. Hear me well when I say this. When you plant your seed and walk away from it, when the time is right, your biggest harvest will be there for you. When the time is right, your biggest harvest will be there for you. Thank you so much for joining me this morning on Coffee and Conversation. I hope that you truly, truly enjoyed it. Thank you, Michelle. Thank you, Gina, so much for hanging out with me this morning. That is right. Seed time and harvest. Seed time and harvest. And that's actually, it's actually three different events. You have your seed, you have your time, and then you have your harvest. You have your seed, you have your time, and you have your harvest. You seed your garden. You wait for the time to happen, and then the harvest is there. Again, thank you all so much for hanging out with me this morning. May God bless you. May God keep you. May you be so deep in the Lord that the enemy would never find you. I'll let you, boy. It's all good. It's all great.
Wake up and smile, 'cause it's been a while. It's been like a whole day since I stopped so you could hold me. But this child awaits, strong in the faith. Lord, you are the refuge that I can't wait to get to, 'cause I can't let a day go. Can't let a day go by without thanking you for the joy that you bring to my life. And it's a beautiful day. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a beautiful day. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When trouble seems to rain on my dreams, it's not a big deal. Let it wash all the bugs off my windshield, 'cause you're showing me that in you I'm free, and you're still the refuge that I've just to get to, so I won't let a day go, won't let a day go by. So put the drop top down, turn it up, I'm ready to fly. And ooh, there's something about the way your sun shines on my face. It's a love so true, I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong, I'm about to get my worship on, take me away. It's a beautiful sing about. There ain't no limitations to your amazing grace, your amazing grace. And there's something about the way your love shines on my face. Oh no, I can never get enough of you.